So this is the real deal.
See,
huh?
This is the real deal, man. There's no iced tea happening here. We're kind of celebrating. I am the new
Absolutely.
My new signature guitar.
Ah,
what time is it? Is it time?
Yeah. That's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Yeah. Don't worry, because I've actually used this since the merger. I've used this since 2004, so this is not like 11 years old. Are we taking a sip?
Whew.
Mark, get in here.
I think they're now bumping this to 11.
Now I know why I don't drink it on a quart bottle anymore.
Cheers.
Long and fruitful.
Hey, welcome to the family.
Thank you. It's great to be great to be part of the family.
It's awesome to keep working together.
Except Mark, you missed him. It all came together, not just a great product that you built for me, but now the relationship and the company with Schecter, with the people there now, that it's pretty much everything, the whole ball of wax is happening now.
I mean, to me it feels right, you know, and you got to speak for yourself, but it's just this instrument and seeing what you've played over the years in different bands and the early band Halen stuff, and even before that, this seems like the right bass and, you know, the right hardware, right, electronics, and just works.
That's not just because you built it, is it?
No.
It's digital.
I think it's going to be a bass that anybody can pick up, a rock guy can pick up, and it's not just, oh, this is a one-trick thing. You know, it's got its bells and whistles without being just over the top.
You got a great set, great pickups, and a great sounding bass, and you let your amp do that part of
Absolutely.
The work, you know, and just, you know, that way I can plug into any kind of amp, and you got a great sound happening here, you know.
So, you know, this bass has the bridge that's machine brass, and then something that we had done on previous things, it's got the strings that go through the body.
Which also helps quite a bit too with the tension when you have singers, or when you want to, you know, you tend to tune down a little bit lower than A440 now. I find that actually helps a little. It helps a bit with the tension on the string a little bit.
It adds almost another 2 inches of string
length,
not in tonality, but in string tension, and which kind of brings us into the finishes on the two USA models. You know, we're going to have the vintage sunburst.
Mm-hmm.
We're also going to have, you know, it's kind of like a European sports car gray. We'll probably name it in time for this show. But it's like a dark gray, black metallic. You know, very sports car-like with the black hardware.
Yeah, something that's a little bit meaner. I mean, something like this, which is kind of vintage-looking.
Right.
You know, I really like. But I also like how we went with this, where it's a little bit more of a industrial, little meaner look. You know,
it definitely has the automotive end of it too. I mean, all the, like, this is actually aircraft aluminum, powder coated. This, you know, and then it gets back to the. Custom neck plate there with your logo and all that stuff. So these will be the two stock finishes, and I know one bass we did in the past, which I think is going to be a great option for, you know, kind of the super fan too is the rat rod finish.
Everybody knew Van Halen when those songs came out. Those were just, everybody knew them. There was a household name at that point.
Yeah, well, songs like Dreams and Right Now, and you know, all of a sudden, all of a sudden, you know, it's kind of felt really strange going to a basketball game and hearing them play Right Now. All of a sudden, they're playing your music at a sports event or whatever, and it's like, oh my God.
So this is a Voids. And an old one at that.
Yeah, actually, it's a 33 Roadster, Ford 33 Ford Roadster. I had it built in 1994, but I'd love to take it out and drive it. And the only problem driving this on the street is that you find you have to watch out more for everybody else looking at your car than what you're doing, because you know I've had more times where people go, "Hey, wow, check out that car!" Next thing you know, they're in your lane.
He came to me and he just, you know, as we were talking and we started doing basses in the custom shop, he said, you know, what do you think about bringing Michael Anthony on? And it took me about 30 seconds and I just went, fuck yeah.
You know, I just tried to find a sound that would, you know, obviously, especially live, that works well with within different players, you know. We all record live as a band because, you know, one thing, the vibe, I think is always better when you're sitting there playing with your bandmates instead of just sitting in a room with headphones on playing to a track by yourself. You know, it's just, there's something magical about it when it's really working. We are actually working on some new demo stuff with Chickenfoot and with a band that Sammy and I put together with his guitarist Vic Johnson and Jason Bonham called The Circle. We were out touring in 2015 and we're going to be out in 2016 playing some shows that I'm sure we're going to hear one of these babies on some new stuff there. I can't wait too. I'm really looking forward to it. I think it's going to sound really good. And I mean, if this is what John, what you guys just showed me, what you could do for me, you know, I'm totally blown away.